From a more domestic spending policy perspective, are the departments of defense and state investing in the right types of resources, and do they have the necessary organizational structures to address these conflicts?
Unfortunately, I don't think. The Defense Department, the Secretary of Defense Gates, has made some wonderful speeches about the way in which in the modern era, security is not gained through military force alone. And we have to have more civilian capacity. We need to send more development specialists, more election monitors, more human rights specialists to these countries, which I completely agree with. But I don't see it. You know, the president has sent 50,000 more troops since he's been in office. And the last count I heard was maybe 600 or 700 additional civilians from the State Department. So the priorities are all wrong. And we are providing a lot of development aid, or what we call development aid. But the biggest portion of it is going through the Pentagon. You know, in Afghanistan, as in Iraq, they have these so-called PRTs, Provincial Reconstruction Teams, completely run by the military. And they're funding good things, building schools, building wells and things, and it's all fine, but it's being done through the military. And so a lot of those activities then become suspect in the communities. Some of them get blown up. Some of the civilians who work in them become threatened by the Taliban and the insurgents. So, I mean, some of the ideas are right. I think the intentions are right, but the tools are wrong. We should be doing this through civilian means. And even the State Department, I would argue, has a limited capacity. I mean, there are lots of civilian non-governmental groups, civil society movements in Afghanistan, as there are in Iraq and all countries around the world. We ought to be identifying the groups that we think have good values that are compatible with ours and supporting them and helping them to improve human rights, to improve social development. They know what they need better than we do. But our aid policies have been shifting away from the civil society NGOs, and as I say, part of it, a big chunk of it, is going through the Pentagon.
In fact, those numbers, the Presidential Council on Faith-Based thing that I was part of, Rich Stearns chaired the Global Poverty Task Force there. And our recommendations to the president included from that task force pointing out that it used to be 40% to 50% of U.S. foreign aid dollars went through independent non-government organizations like World Vision, Catholic Relief Services, and so on. And that shifted now to only 10%, 40% to 10%. So our recommendations were that's the wrong balance, because now a third of our tax dollars for foreign aid go to the Pentagon, a third, and a third more are corporate, Blackwater. So a third corporate, a third military, and only 10% now, when it was 40% for years and years and years. Big shift. Bush started that shift, but Obama hasn't changed it. Other questions? Yes.